On August 5th, 1968, Quaker Sound Studios opened for business at 212 North 12th Street, Philadelphia. The owner, Joe Tarsia, invited a couple of acquaintances to try out his new place. So, writer-producers Kenny Gamble and Leon Huff brought in a rhythm section made of Ronnie Baker, Norman Harris, Earl Young, Bobby Eli, Larry Washington, and Lenny Pakula for a test session. Three songs were recorded: We Don't Need No Music for the Landslides, as well as Ghetto Woman and Rover Rover for Ruth McFadden. After listening to the playbacks, Kenny Gamble simply said, "Sounds great, Joe. We'll use it." And the sound of Philadelphia was born. 5 years later, the very same musicians created disco.
Hi, my name is Weldon Arthur McDougal III from Philly. One day I was coming from a rock and roll show at the Nixon Theater, and I happened to walk down the 53rd Street, and I saw this guy sitting on the step playing a guitar. And so I said, hey man, you wanna play with a group? He said, oh yeah man, I'd love to. That was Norman Harris. But the reason, then I said, well, how long you been playing? He said, I'm taking lessons from Roland Chambers. Now, Roland Chambers is a guy I used to use on all my recordings, but he was getting so popular, I couldn't get him. So I said, Roland is teaching you? He said, yeah. So that's how I got Norman. And I'll never forget, his mother said, listen, Norman can't stay up so late. So I said, that's all right. I don't stay up late anyway. So she said he got a bad heart and everything. And so I used to kind of treat Norman like he was my son. Wouldn't let him drink nothing, you know. But it was interesting. Norman, personally, all he wanted to do was play music. He was a beautiful guy. When he was arranging songs, he used to come to me and let me hear the arrangements. I said, man, I didn't know you could arrange. I mean, he was doing it. Then I met Earl. Well, Earl used to be with a singing group. And the guy who was managing the Larks, it was my group at the time, was managing Earl's group. So when me and the guy broke up, Earl used to hang around with me. So one day we was recording, and the drummer who was supposed to have been there, he didn't show up. So Earl said, I could play drums. And I said, I ain't know that. I said, hey, go get him to hear you. Sound good. And that's how he came part of the rhythm section.
I'm Earl Young, the drummer, Philadelphia. My role in music has been playing drums, singing with the Trammps, having my own recording company called Golden Fleas, along with my partners, Baker, Harris, and Young, and my own publishing company, The Whole Works. So I had a little bit of everything. I got in the Philadelphia scene first by playing in local bands, along with Norman Harris, Ronald Baker, just traveling club to club. And I used to also sing with a group called the Cardells, and Weldon McDougal had a group called the Larks. So Weldon was producing at a place called Virtue Studios, and he brought us in there to record for him. And this was the first time we really got into a recording session, and we cut Barbara Mason, Eddie Holman, Johnny C, called Boogaloo Down Broadway, Yes I'm Ready. And you know, it's kind of funny to go in the studio for the first time and come out with gold records. So that was great. This was before we went with Gamble and Huff and Tommy Bell.
And then Ronnie Baker, I met him. He was over at Harold Lipschitz's Universal Music, Jamie Guyton, I should say. And he was complaining because nobody never used him on bass. I said, well, come over to Frank's, that is Frank Virtue's, you know, and see how you sound, man. He came over and it worked out. The reason those guys worked out, we was all the same kind of guys. We was considered squares, you know. We.
It's like saying, if you have 10 kids, which one do you like? You know, which one you like the best? It's hard to say. That's a very deep question.
Well, as far as disco, that's something that I really started because The Love I Lost was a ballad at first. When we went with the Gamble and Huff, it was a ballad like The Love I Lost. And what I did, I told Gamble, I said, look, we gotta pick this up, man. This is kind of dragging. I said, I want you to try this here, see how you like this. And I started kicking it to the floor four times and 2/4 on the snare and eighth notes on the sock. And, you know, I think it caught his attention. So we left it like that because I was really free to execute my own beats. So they let me just go ahead and free. And I think that's how the Blue Notes got into the disco market, because they weren't really a disco group. But after that song, Bad Luck and The Love I Lost, they became a big disco act too. You know, that's my favorite two songs of all times.
I think Philadelphia dance music existed before the term disco, but the popularity of the music that was coming out of Philly at the time, the dance music, led to other labels and artists emulating the Earl Young sock symbol thing and Ronnie Baker bass lines. And the term disco came about, and you could find people recording music to, you could do the national anthem if you had the right sock symbol beat and rhythm and the right bass line. So I think we found out what disco was after the fact. People just keep bringing up disco. I mean, I played dance music, you know, back in the 50s.
In my opinion, the very first Philadelphia disco track was The Love I Lost by Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes, which in fact started off in the studio as a ballad in a 6/8 time. And the reason being that originally that group of sessions was meant to be recorded by the Dells, and when the Dells deal didn't go down, the songs eventually turned over to Harold Melvin and the Blue Notes when one of the Blue Notes proclaimed to Kenny, hey man, you should try our drummer Teddy. Man, he could sing and he sounds just like that guy in the Blue Notes. So that's what happened. They tried Teddy. Teddy became the lead singer, and the rest is history.